What's up, everyone? How y'all doing? It's your rookie chef, Young Reno, in the house again, y'all. And today we're going to be doing something a little bit fun, all right? Today on my menu, for us rookie chefs, we're going to get a little bit more, we're going to kick it up a notch a little bit more. This time we are going to be making a Cajun citrus seared salmon. That's right, y'all. A Cajun citrus seared salmon. For the first time. So I'm hoping it comes out right, y'all. Y'all know me when I do something for the first time. So far, so good, right? Okay, so for this dish, we're going to be using, I got a nice fresh piece cut of salmon there. You can see it. I got it sitting over some ice right now. I just cleaned it. I'm actually going to cut that in half so I can make it like a fillet. I'm going to have two. We also have some lemon pepper marinade. We have some lemon pepper seasoning. We got two lemons. We ain't going to use two lemons. We're going to use one. But I got lemons, orange. I got an orange, black pepper. We got some Old Bay seasoning. We got some Cajun seasoning. We got butter. And, of course, we got our nice skillet to do our searing in. So I think this is going to come out nice, y'all, all right? So for the first time with this dish, let's get this Cajun citrus seared salmon going. All right, y'all, so what we first gonna start doing is cutting up this citrus, all right? We got an orange and we got a lemon, all right? And I got my cup right here. So what we simply gonna do first, we're gonna take a lemon, we're gonna cut that lemon in half, just like that there. Then we got a squeezer. If you ain't got no juice squeezer, you can use your hands, but make sure you put it underneath so the seeds won't get in there, okay? So let's go ahead and get some fresh lemon juice going in our little cup right here. You're gonna see this. You're gonna see all that good lemon juice. There you go, look at that. All that good lemon juice, okay? Gonna get all of that up in there. Okay, just like that. That's one. And we're gonna do the other one. Just like that. Get it all in there. Okay, just like that there. All right, and as far as our orange go, of course we can't put it in the squeezer because it's too big. So basically what you want to do, you just want to cut it in half. And remember, the easy way to juice these is to make slices like this, like that. And watch this, gonna get a lot of that juice. Look at that, a lot of that juice, see that? That's how you want to get that orange juice out of there. Just like that. Just like that, everyone. Nice and juicy. And then take one more. We're only going to do two. Try to keep it compatible, okay? There we go. There we go. We got a nice little blend. Nice little blend of our lemon juice and our orange juice, right? Okay. So next, what we're gonna do, we're gonna put some of this lemon pepper marinade inside this, like so, just like that, okay? You ain't gotta put too much, boom. I would say maybe a tablespoon and a half, okay? Then you wanna take your lemon pepper, put some lemon pepper in there like that there. I'd say maybe a teaspoon. Your Cajun, again, about a teaspoon. Okay. Your Old Bay. Now I just bought this Old Bay. Yeah, I figured I was gonna have to pop it open. Let me go ahead and get this popped open. Okay, so we're gonna get a little bit of this bay seasoning in there. I already took this little seal off. So we're gonna put a little bit of that in there like this. Just like that. A little bit of that, you know, inside there like that. Like I said, about a tablespoon. Okay, we're gonna put some fresh pepper in here. Just like so. Okay? Just like so. Then what I'm going to simply do, put a little whisk. Oh, and you know what? Let me see. Also a little bit of Creole seasoning, y'all. Don't help. I like my Creole seasoning with everything, so it don't hurt, right? I'll just say put maybe a teaspoon of that in there, all right? Okay, let's go ahead and give it another blend. You know, now all this is going to go in later, all right? There we go. When we have our salmon searing, in that butter that I'm gonna put in that skillet, we're gonna let that butter melt down until it turns brown. We're gonna make brown butter, and then when we make that brown butter, we're gonna let all those milk solids go down into the bottom and make us some brown butter. And then while it's searing, we're gonna pour this nice flavor in. Oh, I think this is gonna be good for the first time, y'all. For the first time, for the rookie chef, for the first time. Okay, so we got that already made to the side. Let's start working on this fish now. Okay, everyone, welcome back. Now let's start doing something to this fish. Let's get this fish seasoned and everything so we can keep this moving. I'm gonna go ahead and get our fish right now. I had it on ice. Look at that. It's a nice piece of salmon, everyone. So what I'm simply gonna do is just cut a little bit of the bottom here, just a little bit. I'm gonna remove a little bit of that bottom. I wanna make some really nice fillets here, okay? So we're gonna go ahead and cut this. Cut this right down the middle here, just like so, okay? I'm gonna make sure I get that. Get that right down the middle like that there. Okay, perfect. Okay, perfect, just like that, okay? So let me move some of this little excess of there. Okay, y'all, here we go. So here's a little trick, y'all. Before I season it up, I'm gonna take my olive oil, right? I'm gonna take my olive oil, now watch closely. I'm just gonna pour a little bit on top, and then I'm gonna rub it just like that. I'm gonna rub the olive oil on the sides, on the top. You can even do it like this too. You can just put it in your hands like that, and then just turn it over and rub it. I'm gonna do both sides. Now what this does is this will definitely help your seasonings absorb, and it'll keep your seasonings from falling off the fish, you know. But olive oil, when you rub it on there, it's gonna make it a really nice texture and flavor, and it's gonna keep them flavors absorbed, okay? So once I rub it in like that, you know, I'm gonna do both sides. Okay, I'm gonna do both sides, right? And like I said, just a little bit, just like that, on the skin. Okay, just like that, right? Keep it all rubbed in, just like so, all right? Just like so. All right. So after we do that, what we're now going to do is we're going to go ahead and season them up a little bit more. Let me wipe my hands a little bit here. Okay, so what we're going to do, again, we're going to go back to that Old Bay seasoning. Even though we put it in our sauce mix over there, we're still going to put it on the fish as well, okay? A little bit of that on there like so. All right. Then we're gonna also put a little lemon pepper again. Okay. A little bit of Cajun. Then black pepper. Then what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna pat it just like that. patty, just like that. Let them flavors absorb in that olive oil, and they simply won't fall off, as you can see. Okay? I'm gonna go ahead and season the other side. Okay? Just like so, everyone. Okay? Old day on here. All right. And my lemon pepper. I think I put some on there, but it's okay. Put a little more on there. Now, just gonna rub that just like that. Tap it. Tap it on there like that. Okay. Flip them back over. As you can see, the seasoning is still there. Nothing fell off. That's what I'm talking about. That's the purpose of the olive oil. Okay. Okay, now that we got that seasoned, what I'm going to simply do now, is I'm going to take this, put it in the refrigerator for a second, let it stay chilled, and I want that to stay chilled, okay? In the meantime, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and get that butter in that pan. I got that butter turned up. Oops, I almost messed up, y'all. Got that butter in that pan, get that butter in that pan. Let it start searing, and I'm gonna show y'all what I mean when I say brown butter, okay? So we'll be right back to that after this. Okay, welcome back, y'all. So I got my pan hot right now. So basically, we're gonna have it on a medium high, all right? A medium high, you know, right in the middle. I'm gonna go ahead and drop this butter in there, and I'm gonna take another little piece of butter that I had put away that I'm not using, so I'm gonna throw that in there as well. All right, and what we want that to do is just simply melt down. All right, and while that is melting down, what I'm gonna be do, take my spatula, and I'm just gonna move it around like so, kind of help it out. Okay, this is the kind of look you're gonna be getting. Can you see that? So what we're gonna do right now, we're just gonna go ahead and we're just going to go out and do this. We're going to let this butter cook down. And what's going to happen is you're going to see it foaming up. It's going to start foaming up real good. And when it starts foaming up, you're going to notice that it's going to start turning brown. Basically, that's the milk solids inside. You know, it's going to start going to the bottom. It's going to start foaming up. It's going to give us that nice brown butter texture. You know, and then when that starts happening, we know we're in the right track, okay? So let's get that butter to start looking like that. And when it starts looking like that, we'll be right back. Okay, welcome back, folks. Now y'all can see. Let me let y'all see this butter. Y'all see that? See how it's starting to foam? Y'all see how it's starting to brown up a little bit and foam? That's what you want to see. That's what you want to start seeing. Start seeing it do that. You know, and I'm about to put these nice salmons in there in a few minutes. I'm going to just kind of let it do its thing for, I would say, maybe... I'd say maybe a couple more minutes. Okay, a couple more minutes. All right? And then we're going to go ahead and get these babies in there. You know, butter's looking good. All right? And usually, too, with your salmon, you can, a matter of fact, you know what? I think I'm going to do that. Because you can definitely do this, too. So, I'm going to take this... this other lemon right here. You know, I'm going to get my grater. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to put a little zest on top of it, on top of the skin, the non-skin part, okay? Just going to rub a little like that. Just like that. Just like that. Put a little zest. Ain't nothing going to hurt. All that's going to do is even help the flavor, help the flavor even more, you know? Okay, folks, that brown is there. We have our brown butter. So let's go ahead and start doing these now. You know, we're going to do skin up first, okay? Skin up is when I'm going to start my frying. Y'all going to hear this. Listen. Hear that nice sound? Don't you just love that sound? Skin up, everyone. There we go. Just like that. Okay? Just like that. You know, and while that's doing that, I'm just going to be, you know, constantly just, boy, it just smells so good. I'm just going to be, you know, just kind of like putting it on top, you know, like that. Like that, and just, you know, patting it on top just like that. So what I'm simply going to do is wait till I start seeing it turn white at the bottom. Once I start seeing it turn white halfway up, then I'm going to flip it over. I'm going to do this about three minutes on each side, okay? 3 minutes on each side. There we go. 3 minutes on each side, okay? This is going to be so delicious. I can already tell this is going to be so delicious for the first time. I feel like I know what I'm doing, even though I ain't never done this before, but I feel I know what I'm doing. And like I said, got a lot of chefs out there who I look up to that gives me the confidence and the ideas to do this as a rookie chef. So all my rookie chefs at home that want to do this can do it too. You feel me? That's how we work that. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and let this start doing this thing. Then I'm going to flip it over. And then I'm going to be right back with y'all to keep y'all updated. Welcome back. Y'all just turned them over. You want to see how this looking now? Oh my, look at this. Ain't those looking so good? Those are looking good. You know what I'm going to try next time when I do this? I'm going to get some cherry red potatoes. You know, little small red potatoes. Little small ones look like cherries. And I'm going to cook them in this with this. You know, it's just an idea. But there y'all go. You see, ain't that looking good? So now what we're going to do now is remember that beautiful season we made? The sauce? Remember this? Going to go ahead and pour that in here right now. Just like so. There we go. There we go. Now, I'm going to let that marinate and cook in here on these salmons, you know. And this is going to be some yummy stuff, y'all. I'm trying to tell y'all. This is going to be some yummy stuff. All right? So now, what we're going to do is let that cook in that for a minute. I'm going to start, you know, kind of bathing it in the salmon to keep that flavor going, to keep that good flavor going. Oh my God. Ooh, it smells so good. All right? So we're going to go ahead and let this get to going. And then when they're done, I'm going to let you see them again. And then after that, I'm going to start doing the plating. We're going to do a taste test. And we're going to be done, folks, just like that. Rookie Steph White, just like that. Okay, y'all, look how this came out. We're not done yet. Look at that. Ain't that salmon beautiful? So what I'm simply doing is cooking down this juice a little bit more, because we're going to put that as a sauce. I'm going to sauce it up a little bit more when that's done. Think about it. That's that orange, that fresh orange juice, lemon juice, and all those seasonings that we mixed up in that. You know, that's why we call this the Cajun Citrus Seared Salmon. Cajun citrus seared salmon. That's why we call it that. You know what I mean? So once that get going, I'm going to put it all on that. Next up is the plating, the taste test, and then we're going to keep it rocking. How beautiful that's looking. Oh my God. Okay, here's the deal, right? It's done. And I'm going to tell you like this. To be the rookie chef and to try things for the first time, man, I put my foot into this one for the first time. I think I did myself. The presentation is very simple but nice. I want y'all to see how this came out, y'all. Here is my Cajun citrus seared salmon. Right here, y'all. Take a look at this and tell me what y'all think for the first time. A first time person making this. Look at this, y'all. Look at this. Look at this. You can't tell me it don't look good for a rookie. For a rookie chef, it don't look bad, right? For a rookie chef, it looks damn good. Look at this. Look at this. We made that. Okay? We made that. It's Cajun citrus seared salmon, y'all. We got that fresh orange juice, that fresh lemon juice, all mixed up. And then we got that sauce we made with the same seasoning and that butter. I went on and gave it a little bath with that salt, that sauce, and it stuck on there. Look at that, y'all. There you go. Cajun citrus seared salmon. I can't wait to bite, to put the fork in there to see how fluffy, how good it came out. That's going to be the next test, y'all. Are y'all ready for that? Y'all ready for the next test? I think I'm ready for the next test, too. All right. I just wanted y'all to just really see that. All right. All right. So y'all know what we about to do now, right? Let's make it. Let's get it in. All right. Let's get it in. All right. Let me go ahead and move some of our nice little. Oh my God. All right, y'all. I'm gonna show y'all on this fork. Let me go ahead and. Oh man. Look at that. Look at that. You can taste the orange and lemon perfectly. Not salty, nothing.